come to Food to See You. So as we all know, nammal Lemirin-il nikkana, and of course Lemirin means executive chef JP Singh. So let's go and meet with him. Wow!
Hello, how are you?
I'm surprised to see you here today at the pastry shop.
Wanna have some chocolate?
Yeah, would love
pick up
to.
A piece.
I can?
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Which is this chocolate?
This is dark chocolate and milk chocolate with nuts.
Milk chocolate.
Yeah, yeah. Pick up
so
one.
I'll pick up one dark chocolate.
Yeah.
Alright.
Done.
So this is special for today?
Yes.
Wow.
So
how is it made? You have a lot of nuts, you have walnut,
chocolate and
you
nuts.
Have cashew nuts.
Yes. Yeah, super
chocolate.
Food.
Super.
So where are we going today?
So well, you could easily guess. Some like how you remember? We had went last time to Eastern Masala's MT's house.
Mm-hmm.
Today we are going to Melam Masala. Melam is also
okay.
One of the leading masalas.
Mm-hmm.
So which we normally cook in our food for our typical Kerala food, we normally use those
good.
Masalas. So today we are going to their MD's house.
Wow.
It's very famous. Melam Masala is very famous. And of course they are put up here in Cochin. So they have welcomed us today.
Let's go.
So let's surprise them with our delicacies as usual.
Sure.
So her name is Mrs. Sujata Kurian.
Mrs. Sujata Kurian.
Sujata Kurian. You might have heard of her. So, we'll go her and meet, and then we'll start off with our journey. All right.
Done.
All right. So done. Let's come out. Today about the Melam curry powder, the masalas and the different products that you're introducing in the market and how far it has been going on a large scale and successfully.
It's 24 years.
Wow. Years, just one more year for a silver jubilee. Probably we'll come over here and celebrate the silver jubilee with Melam masalas. Okay, so apart from business, where in the areas lana activity irikkunna?
Actually yangal social service aanu yanku kudile ente husband industries nekkal arinnene kaattum he likes to be known as a social entrepreneur.
Oh wow, that's something
that's
really
nice.
Good to hear from such a
I've heard a lot about Melam masala social activities and stuff what they
oh.
do for the community and the people, so really good sir. I have heard about sir, so really good work that
that's a good
doing.
Thing, no? To be a part of business and at the same time, working elsewhere.
Yeah,
and
actually, he started Melam to do this charity work.
Charity
wow.
work.
That's so nice.
In fact, probably it is one of a kind in India or probably in the world that one has ventured into business for helping the poor in India or the underprivileged.
That's really
why
good.
The Indian government in 2010 awarded Padma Shri.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow, that's an honor to be in this house now.
Wow,
yeah. So,
it's really an honor for
Kerala.
Me to be in this house.
He's the only one in Kerala who was awarded Padma
Shri. Privileged,
wow.
really privileged to be here.
Really nice.
Really privileged to be here, right?
Yeah.
So it's really a good thing.
No, it's a privilege for us and a pleasure for
sure.
us to have a chef from our family.
Yeah.
And Dhanya, right?
Yes.
So Dhanya, are you like interested in getting into Melam business apart from your teaching profession, right? You're into as a lecturer, you're working
yes,
as a lecturer.
Yes, I'm doing my PhD in corporate social responsibility.
Mm-hmm. You're also into social responsibilities and
yes,
activities,
yes.
Huh? Same
in
father's
life.
Like.
From the time we were in school, my parents used to ensure that we are also involved in the charitable activities every second Saturday. We used to sit with them and
oh.
interact with the patients who come and all that. So they
That's
kind of brought us up that way.
So probably we can have Dhanya as a sole successor of Melam in the near future.
God allows, God willing.
God willing. Oh, that's really good. So ma'am, we want to see your kitchen.
Yeah, sure.
Please guide us.
What we have now is we've got all the Melam masalas.
Mm.
Okay, in this box I've
That's
got
a
some lovely stuff.
For it.
Yes. So I have some soya badi.
Mm.
Okay. With this we will boil and we'll make a kebab.
Kebab? Wow, that's wonderful.
Okay. Then we've got
vermicelli
mix. With this we will make a dessert. We've got some chicken masala, I've got some chicken there. We will do a chicken dish.
Oh.
And then we have curry mein. So we will do a curry mein Asian style.
Curry mein?
Yes.
Wow.
Okay, so we have kebab. North Indian style.
Soya kebab.
Yes. Then we will do a kareem in Asian style.
Asian style.
Then we will make a rice and we have chicken. So we'll chicken, we will do a creamy sort of curry. We will give them all flavors.
Creamy chicken.
Creamy chicken, continental style.
Continental style. Asian continental, pata nahi, my mouth is getting filled with water.
And then we have dessert, which is vermicelli.
We have ice creams also inside. Let's see if it could do
we have something. Vermicelli mix, okay. So with this, I will do a dessert. Payasam, this is local payasam, but I will give it a twist.
എക്സിക്യൂട്ടീവ് ഷെഫാണ്. ചേച്ചിയുടെ പേര് എങ്ങനെയായിരുന്നു?
രാധാമണി.
ഓക്കെ, അപ്പൊ ചേച്ചി ഇന്ന് നമ്മളെ ഷെഫാണ്. എല്ലാം എന്താ പറയാ, ഇവിടുത്തെ കംപ്ലീറ്റ് ഷെഫാണ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്. സോ വി ഹാവ് ദ ബ്രോക്കലീസ് ഓൾസോ, വി ഗോട്ട് ദ മഷ്റൂംസ്.
യെസ്, യു ആർ ഓൾറെഡി ബോയിലിംഗ് പൊട്ടാറ്റോസ് ആൻഡ് ഐ ഓൾസോ ബോയിൽഡ് ദ
സോയാ
ചങ്ക്സ്. സോ വാട് വിൽ ഹാപ്പൻ ഈസ് till the time it gets soft, we will drain all the water and then we will make crush them and then we will mix it with potato and some spices to make kebabs.
Wow, so it's going to be a spicy one, I suppose.
Yes. So in the meantime, what I'll do is I'll cut my other things. I've got my onions, mushrooms, so I will start cutting all those things so that once we are cutting is done, we will
shift to the cooking part.
While she is washing the rice, I have some lovely curry beans. Wow. So I will just wash them.
These curry beans are very popular, the eastern part of Kerala. That is Alappi side.
Okay. What I have done is I have gone to Kumarakam.
Yes,
I did
there
fishing
also.
There. Wow. I did my own fish fishing. I enjoyed there and I cooked it on a boat.
Oh, wow, that was really adventurous.
Yes.
We can do it someday.
Done. So what I'll do now is your rice is done. So you can do with
just
the rice.
One more to go.
Yes, and then you just soak it and keep it for 20 minutes, 20 to half an hour.
I'll just strain this off and then we'll keep
put
it
another
soaked.
Water, some more water.
So we'll keep it aside. Meanwhile, we'll go into the cutting part. As you said, okay. Yes, we
have
curry mean.
Yes, so I will just make scars like this.
You got these big ones itself when you went for fishing?
They were much bigger.
Much bigger. It's yummy, you know, when it comes to Kerala foods. You can't substitute it with any other.
Kerala food is so nice. It's got so much of diversity in the food. So many different styles.
Mixing everything.
Especially like the northern part of Kerala, the Mapla cuisine.
Wow.
The Malabari food, I really love that.
Yes, the other day we had the Kalumakayas and
yes.
Everything.
everything has its own distinct flavors in Kerala. Like Mapla, they have their own flavors, their own style of cooking. Sadhya, it's unique.
And even the biryani
experience.
Has different versions, tastes and even colors also.
Exactly. So Sadhya has its own flavor. Anybody coming to Kerala, Sadhya meal, if he doesn't have Kerala experience, is not.
It's totally incomplete.
And then you can't forget the Syrian food, the roast, the duck roast, the chicken roast.
Wow. So chef has a lot to say about Kerala cuisine.
Yes,
that's
lots.
Really good to hear from a Punjabi.
So what we will do now is we have our fish ready. Okay. Then we've got some soybean sauce here, okay.
All
then
right.
We have celery here, so I will chop the celery nicely.
Okay.
You can get me a plate so that we can marinate and keep it.
Oh, fine. Oh yeah, see someone is
Hi.
Here to.
How are you?
I'm here to see some. Some tips and
so what we are doing right now is, just to brief you up, I have some kareem in. I'm doing a Asian style kareem in.
Nice.
Okay,
it's good that you had kareem in over
it's
here.
A very common fish here. Everybody loves kareem in. So let's try doing something different with the kareem in.
It is something I miss in Delhi.
Yes.
Yeah. Are we not adding any vinegar?
We will add everything. Once we add in all these things, after that we will add the vinegar. We have some nice natural vinegar here.
Natural vinegar.
So we will add that.
Wow. So Dhanya, probably you can also get into the cooking line very slowly and get tips from him. So you can try this next time.
Yes, yes, I'm waiting to. That's why.
Do you get these curry means there? No.
But
yes,
I do take
available
frozen curry means from Kerala to Delhi.
Melam
soy sauce.
Wow. Yeah.
She takes frozen curry means from here to Delhi, and that's how she cooks there.
Yes. Uh-huh.
All right. So if you could see this, he's marinating the fish.
What we will do is we will take the stuffing, and we will push it inside.
Oh, it's stuffed curry means.
Not stuffed. We are just pushing these curry means
over
when
the
three.
Flavors.
Yes. Because what will happen is when we will cook it, all these flavors will release, and all this will go inside. We have our chicken here, we've got all the ingredients what we want. We will start cooking the chicken. Okay.
Okay.
There also they have some extra virgin.
Extra virgin.
Extra light olive oil. So we will add this. And then we have some garlic.
We need to crush them again.
Yes. And we will chop them this time. A little bit, not too much. So this goes inside.
Mm-hmm.
I've got some onions. Nicely sliced.
You require something to stir it, right?
Yes.
So we sorted the onions and so we are cutting the mushrooms.
Yes.
The major ingredient in this dish.
Major ingredient is chicken. So once our onion is almost done,
sorted.
We will add our chicken.
As it is, huh?
Yes.
You don't want to add any masala or anything? Oh, so this is not gonna be spicy.
Not gonna be spicy.
Okay, so though we are making a continental dish, it will be however incomplete, especially coming to such a place and
exactly.
Not using
so
the melam masala.
We have got some nice, lovely chicken masala of melam. So what we will do is we will use the melam chicken masala. We will not add much, we will just add for the flavor, we will add 1 teaspoon of the masala.
Yes, that's enough.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now what we will do is we will add the mushrooms as well.
Mm-hmm.
So that the mushrooms can also leave its flavor in the dish.
Continental food doesn't involve much of cooking with masala, so it's just simply eating fresh and raw, which is healthy.
Not raw exactly, but what they do is they cook.
They cook slightly, only a very little amount of cooking is involved.
Yeah. They cook it nicely, but for flavors, they are not used to the so spices.
Masalas and all, like
yes.
How we do.
So now what we have to do is,
mm-hmm.
We will just put some water in this.
Okay.
Okay,
I'll just
and
get
leave
some
it.
Water.
Yeah. Put that water, let it cook.
Yes.
Okay, we
and
will cover it.
Cover
and
it with
yes.
The lid.
And let it cook for 20
so
minutes.
Continental chicken is almost getting ready. So
okay.
We finally took out the potatoes. Now we are moving on to the soya kebab.
Yes, what we will do now is we will have these lovely soya kebabs.
Soya chunks.
We will take out all the water like this. Okay, and then
squeeze it really well.
Squeeze
so that
it
the water
nicely
is really
so that all the water is out, and then we will
put into a mixer.
Yes, and we will make a nice keema. And in the meantime I do this, you can peel the potatoes. How are you?
Aroma. With melam curry powder.
So what we are doing now is yes. We are making some kebabs.
Oh,
okay.
Soya kebabs.
So in that soya kebabs, what we've done so far is we've boiled the soya beans. We've added some potato. We've added some besan to it.
Mm.
Now we will add the masalas. Melam masalas.
Melam masalas to give it the real taste. So adding a little bit of salt.
Chicken. Which one? This is a cream chicken with some mushrooms. And I've added some chicken masala, the melam chicken masala as well. Yes. A little chili powder, a little coriander powder. Salt is already added.
So we added some coriander leaves also to the kebab mixture.
We got some kishmish.
We have some cashews we already got.
Let's taste it, it's almost done. Wow, so delicious. I'm telling you guys, you need to try this recipe at home. It's really, really, really swadelicious.
We can try recipes, but the exact taste is in the hands of JP Singh.
And now, last thing what we will do is...
some fresh cream.
Yes, we will add the cream.
When it comes to cream and butter, our chef is really generous. Doesn't compromise at all.
Yes. If you have to cook it nicely, you want the real flavors, you should not compromise with things, ingredients.
Are simple mein bol do na, abhi Punjabi.
So now,
now
what we
I
will
guess
do is,
we have to taste it once again.
Yes, now the dish is done. What I will do now is, we have some celery in the fridge.
Yeah.
I will add some celery leaves on top.
Done. Mm. Chef, it's really tasty. I don't know when you are going to cook this for me.
Wow. Awesome.
So
our chicken dish
done.
Is done.
We'll keep
Let's
it aside.
Keep it on the side. Okay. And in the meantime, our rice is here. We will start cooking our rice. Should we cook the rice Indian way or a Conti way?
Because we already cooked the chicken in a Conti way. We'll have the rice on in a Conti way. Let's
done.
Have two Conti dishes.
Done. So now what we are doing is, we are cooking the rice. We are making
in a continental way.
Yes. We are making a pilaf.
Pilaf?
Yes. So we will take a little bit of oil,
okay,
olive oil, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to add butter to this.
Okay,
so now what we will do is we will add the onions.
It's like
now
a mixture itself,
I'm adding some cashew nuts. It's a cashew nut pilaf.
Okay.
My rice to it. So now what we will do is, we have got some melam
vermicelli
paisam mix. So we will use this to make a dessert. Okay. Yes. So as the direction says, follow the direction. We will take the mix and add milk and cook for 10 minutes. You don't need to be a chef to make this. We will just take half of the packet.
Oh, we have the mixing, the everything over.
Everything is there. So we will add the milk. That's it. You don't have to do anything else. That's the easy part of melam paisam mix. Let it boil, cook for 10 minutes, and we will keep it aside. And after that, we will do something really cool with this. So now our rice is done, our chicken is done, our kebab is in the fridge, and fish is in the fridge. Dessert is almost there. So let's finish the dessert now. And after that, we will start doing the kebabs and the fish. So this is in the meantime getting cooled. What I'm going to do is, I have some glasses here. Whoa. I'm going to use these glasses for our presentation of the dessert. The paisam is already cooled. And what we will do is, we will take the thick part.
Whoa.
And on top. Done. That's it. Don't have to do add much. It just
because we already have the cake and the fig.
Yes.
Okay.
So it will look nice. Done. Our dessert looks nice.
Wow, looks nice. And I feel like tasting it. Wow, it's just simply yummy.
Clean it and we will keep it in fridge so that it gets more cold and nice. Take our pan and we will start cooking the kebabs.
Okay, I'll take out this kebab mixture.
Yes.
of cooking.
So everything is done.
The kebabs are already in the plate.
Yes, yeah. Everything is done. Our last dishes are karimeen, so we're going to start that. I'm going to take some oil and we're going to just do a little small shallow frying of the fish. It has got soya, garlic, you had some nice celery. So we'd add that, salt, seasoning into it. Our oil is hot and we will add this in. So in the meantime it gets ready. We can just wait outside. Let's set up the table.
And yeah, we'll set up the table.
I'll plate everything and we'll come with the food
apart
outside.
Apart from all this, we have a surprise inside the fridge also, which will be there on the table. So you can please go once again. How is it? To compliment the plate, we have the eggs also and something else.
And you've got some desserts as well.
So many dishes in such a short time. Amazing.
Wow. So you have a lovely lunch today, right? Hope you're all very glad to have it. And we are also once again glad to have you, you know, in this place, coming here and cooking.
And as we said, it's a pleasure. It was an honor to cook for you guys and such a honorable house. Thank you so much for getting us here. And we should move on now. Please enjoy your lunch. And we'll see you soon sometime.
Yeah, later. By the way, the family, someone is incomplete. Our Padma Shri honor.
Actually,
he's busy. Oh. All right, just convey our regards and ask him to watch the show as well. Yeah, he missed it. But we have something left for him, I guess. Or else, Dania, you can prepare for him later because you have already learned a bit of the recipes. Yes. So guys, enjoy. No more waiting.
This was another episode of Food to See You. Keep watching the show. You might be the next. We might ring at your house.
So we'll be back with Food to See You to see you again. Till then, bye-bye.
കപ്പാറ്റിക്ക് വേണ്ടി നമ്മുടെ വീട്ടിൽ വന്നിങ്ങനെ ഷെഫ് വന്നിങ്ങനെ ഫുഡ്. പക്ഷെ ഞാൻ ഒരിക്കലും ഓർത്തില്ലെങ്കിലും ലേമറഡിയിലെ ഷെഫ് വന്നിങ്ങനെ ഇത്രയും ഞാൻ ഒരിക്കലും ഓർത്തില്ല. അപ്പൊ തന്നെ നീ അവധിക്ക് വന്നോണ്ട് നിനക്ക് ഇതെല്ലാം
തോന്നും.
വളരെ ഫാസ്റ്റ് ആയിട്ടല്ലേ, വളരെ ടേസ്റ്റി ആയിട്ട്. കബാബ് ഒക്കെ എന്തൊക്കെ ടേസ്റ്റ് ആയിരുന്നു,
വെരി സോഫ്റ്റ് ടേസ്റ്റ്. ശരിക്കും പഞ്ഞി പോലത്തെ കബാബ്.
Cashew rice, even this cashew rice.
Very nice.